Hi everybody, let's discuss some of the interview questions in RPA, one of the RPA tool UiPath. Let's start with question 1. So what is the first test method of inputting some text or clicking into an application? Okay, so what I mean is, let's say if you are giving a click on any application, or let's say you are typing something into an application, so what is the first test method can I do this? Okay, so if I drag and drop the type into activity, so if I click this similar type to true, okay, so out of the three input methods, default, send Windows messages and similar type is the first method. Okay, again, let's say I have some 5 type into activities, I can simply put them in one parallel activity again, so that the execution will be even more faster. Okay, so the fastest method of inputting anything to an application is nothing but you have to use the similar type and put all your activities inside the parallel activity, so that the execution will be very fast. Okay, what is REF? REF is nothing but it's a robotic enterprise. It's just a template that, you know, we can use to start developing the solution. Okay, by default it will have all the best practices like exception handling, queue usage, all those things. So how we can import this is, so if we go to the home page of UiPath, I can select the robotic enterprise framework. I can give the name based on the naming convention, and I will create my own process. By default, it will have several workflows to get credentials for queue-related things. So it is in most of 20 to 30% of the development is already done in this framework. You can directly use this framework to start your solution. Okay, how to filter records in a data table? We can have two methods to filter a data table. We can use select method. So whatever the data table you have, just type a dot, and if you type select inside the brackets, you will give your conditions like column name equal to value, and again you can give as many conditions you want, or else you can directly use the filter data table activity. You can specify the number of conditions in this activity, and you can use this filter data table activity inside your workflow. Let's go to the next question. What is the difference between data scraping and screen scraping? Okay, data scraping is nothing but you are scraping data, structured data, like, you know, websites. If you open Google and type any website, you will get a list of websites. That is nothing but a structured data, like tables, all these are structured data. However, screen scraping is nothing but if you get data from a specified element in an application, you will use screen scraping. Again, screen scraping, you have three techniques, full text, native and OCR. So we can use whichever we want, but full text will be faster, and using OCR sometimes you may get some bad results using OCR. So depending upon your situation, you can use either of these, native, full text or OCR engine. How to read mail from subfolders in an inbox? Let's say you have inbox in your Outlook mail, and inside that there is one more folder called folder 1. Again, inside folder 1 there is folder 2. Let's say if I want to read mails in this folder 2, okay, so in get Outlook message activity, the mail folder property I have to specify like this, like inbox/folder1/folder2. So how to manage credentials in UiPath? In UiPath we can create credentials either in the orchestrator or in the Windows credential manager. So whenever we are creating a credential, we should give the name to the particular credential. We will give this name again in the config file. So whenever the bot is reading the config file, it will take the credential name and pass it to either orchestrator or Windows credential manager, and it will get the credentials from there. How to distribute workload in UiPath? Okay, distributing workload is nothing but, let's say, if the volume of automation is large and using one bot is not enough, you can deploy two or more bots into your production environment, so that all these work on the same work queue and distribute the load to each process. With this, we can make use of queues to achieve this. Okay, how to work with REST API? To make REST API calls, we can use utility HTTP activity. say this is the HTTP request activity, you can pass the endpoint URL, and you can pass the body and the format. So what we get is we will get a result which is in JSON format. So we have to deserialize this JSON format, okay, and we will get the data table which will be used for further processing. Okay, what are the different statuses a bot have? Okay, let's say if the bot is running any process, the status in the orchestrator it will be showing as busy. So this indicates a process currently running on this particular resource. You say if the status is available, okay, the bot is free to be used, no process is executing on this particular bot at this point of time. If it shows disconnected, that indicates that the robot and got disconnected from orchestrator and there is no communication between these two from the last 2 minutes. Unresponsive is nothing but in Windows services, the UiPath robot services is not running. We have to manually go there and restart the service. And the last question is, what are the queue item statuses? So whenever we add the items, to the queue, so what different statuses we can see in the orchestrator queue section? Okay, the first status is new. Whenever we add a new item to the queue, the status will be shown as new. So it can be picked by any process using get transaction data activity. So and the next status is in progress. Let's say whenever a bot picked the item from the queue, the status will be changed from new to in progress. Okay, so and then failed is nothing but suppose in your process if there is an exception and you manually you try catch block to catch that exception, and you manually have used the code to change the status of this particular item to failed. So for that we will use set transaction activity to change the status of that particular item. Again, successful if the item went successful, and we can use set transaction status activity to again to change the status to successful. Okay, retried is nothing but we can specify the number of attempts while creating the queue itself, or else we can specify the items in the config file as well. But if we specify the items in config file, then there is no need to specify in the queue items. Okay, so again, if an item is being retried, the item, the status will be shown as retried. So after retrying the item, again it will change status either to failed or successful. Deleted is nothing but if you add the duplicate items to the queue, and if you want to delete them so that no bot will pick it and process them, you can select those items in the queue and you can right click and delete all those items. Abandoned is nothing but let's say if the item status is in progress and the status is not updated within 24 hours, then the status will automatically will change it to abandoned. Okay, these are some of the interview questions in UiPath. Okay, hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you.